6 ATPs are released. And to coming to the next step, what is the next step? Pyruvic acid, oxidative decarboxylation. Oxidative decarboxylation. Here, for one glucose molecule, how many oxidative decarboxylation reactions are carried out? How many? Two. So, number of oxidative decarboxylations are how many? Two. Here, how many NADH2s are released? Released NADH2s, how many? Two. Two NADH2s are released. Oxidative phosphorylation, oxidative phosphorylation of NADH2 during the oxidative phosphorylation. Number of oxidative decarboxylation reactions carried out during the second step of aerobic respiration, they are 2. It means here 2 NADH2s are released. For 1 NADH2, how many ATPs are released here? 3 ATPs are released. Okay. How many NADH2s are here? 2 NADH2s are here, that resulted to 2 into 3, they are 6 ATPs. 6 ATPs. So in the glycolysis, how many ATPs? 6 ATPs. In the pyruvic acid oxidative decarboxylation, how many ATPs? 6 ATPs. Totally 12 ATPs. Then you, in Krebs cycle, substrate level of ATPs. It means ATP formed at substrate level. Substrate level phosphorylation. Phosphorylation. It means here do not produce the direct ATP, but they are produced in the form of GTPs. How many GTPs? 2 GTPs are released. So, 1 GTP is equivalent to 1 ATP. Hence, 2 ATPs are produced in Krebs cycle at substrate level of phosphorylation. Next, where the GTP is produced means at succinyl CoA to succinic acid. Succinyl CoA to succinyl succinic acid production. Okay, and the next is ATP from NADH2. ATP from NADH2. Number of ATPs, number of NADH2s are produced during the Krebs cycle are how many? 8. 8 NADH2s are released. Number of NADH2 produced in Krebs cycle are 6. First one is at isocitric acid to oxalosuccinic acid. Oxalosuccinic acid. Here one NADH2 is produced. And next one is alpha ketoglutaric acid to succinyl CoA. Succinyl CoA. And the last one is malic acid to OAA production. So in these three reactions, three NADH2s are produced. Totally six NADH2s are produced. Okay. For each NADH2, how many ATPs? Three ATPs. So you write as 2 into 3 ATPs, 2 into 3 ATPs, and 2 into 3 ATPs. 2 into 3, 6, 6 plus 6. Totally how many ATPs here? 18 ATPs are resulted here. 18 ATPs. And next, ATP is formed from FADH2. Where the FADH2 is reduced? Between fumaric acid to succinic acid to fumaric acid. Succinic acid to fumaric acid. Fumaric acid. How many? 2. So 2 into, for one FADH2, how many ATPs are released? 2 ATPs are released. So they are totally how many? 4 ATPs. 4 ATPs. You see, in the Krebs cycle, the ATP is formed three level. One is substrate level of phosphorylation, and another one is ATP is formed from NADH2, and ATP also formed from FADH2. First substrate level of phosphorylation resulted how many ATPs? 2 ATPs, especially in Krebs cycle. And from NADH2, how many ATPs are produced? 18 ATPs are produced. From FADH2, how many ATPs? 4 ATPs are produced. It means in Krebs cycle, the formed ATPs are, formed ATPs are 2 plus 18 plus 4. That equal to 24 ATPs. 24 ATPs totally during the formed during the Krebs cycle. And total respiration. So come to the total respiration means aerobic respiration. So aerobic respiration means that equal to glycolysis, Krebs cycle, sorry, pyruvic acid, oxidative decarboxylation plus Krebs cycle. So during the glycolysis, how many? 6 ATPs. 6 ATPs during the pyruvic acid oxidative decarboxylation, how many ATPs are yielded? 6 ATPs. During the Krebs cycle, 24 ATPs are produced. The total number of ATPs are produced if one molecule of glucose oxidized. So you see here, 6 plus 6, 12, 12 plus 24, 36. So the 36 ATPs are resulted. 36 ATPs are resulted. It means the balance sheet of ATP production in aerobic oxidation of one glucose molecule, that is equivalent to 36 ATPs.